we're seeing the Sensex trade about 13, 13 and a half time forward, 12-month forward earnings.
Yeah.
How do you see the markets positioned? If you just keep aside the election outcome, do you think from a valuation standpoint, it's looking attractive to you?
I think we need some kind of back-of-the-envelope math. Then. Mm. Clearly, I think the valuation is of two aspects. One is, of course, the longer term, what is the 10-year average valuation at which we trade. Mm. Clearly, if you look at the current valuations with respect to the 10-year average PE multiples, mm. we are below that.
Okay.
There is no doubt on that. But the question is, what is the PE multiple which is acceptable, mm. given the fact that the rate of growth for the Indian economy also is down.
Right.
In that context, if you look at it, yes, the PE multiple currently is justified.
Sure.
The market always have got some kind of expectation that is getting built in. As mm. I mentioned in the beginning, mm. the expectations also need to get captured. Mm. Right now, what is getting captured is some bit of hope, but not so much actually on the improvement of the economic fundamentals.
Sure.
So, I think these two combinations, if it comes into play, mm. There is a high probability that the valuations will start catching up, mm. expecting that 2015-2016 earnings will get better
sure.
on the back of what could be done in the next 6 months to 1 year time frame.
The large part of last year, Bala, I remember we were having a conversation as well, that we spoke about the rupee. You know, we spoke about the fact that there was quite a bit of volatility. You saw the extraordinary measures by the RBI, liquidity infusing and so on. Would you say that the problems concerning the trade deficit, the current account balance is behind us? Would you believe that this year you're going to see perhaps the rupee trade in a more narrow range?
Sure. I think clearly the effort that was, I think, as going behind mm. in ensuring the current account deficit is contained, mm. I think we have achieved a big success in that. Then second biggest achievement which has come in the last 6 months to maybe 4 to 5, 6 months time frame mm. is actually the bringing down the volatility that we have seen mm. for a very long period of time in the both in the bond market as well as the currency market mm. And also the equity market. I think that I would assume that the biggest change that has come for the Indian market is actually the heightened volatility which we used to be there in the past and has calmed down quite a lot. Mm. Now from here onwards, I think for next 1 to 1.5 years time frame, the recent policy measures I think will probably play out quite well. Mm. At the same time, we can't live actually on a scenario that yes, everything is now is more or less done and we will not face this problem once again. Mm. Clearly, I think the efforts, I think probably we should go behind in the next maybe 3 months to a year or so.
Sure.
Used to get FDI investments so that you make the, actually the flow more consistent mm. and in a continuous kind of efforts, mm. not just only through the capital flows, both in the form of portfolio flows as well as the flows in the bond market.
Right.
I think it has to go beyond that, mm. which is in the form of an FDI.
Okay.
I think there is already there are some math which we have done internally. Mm. There are a few companies who have announced FDI investment into the country.
And some is waiting the wings.
No, some is waiting the wing. Mm. But some of them actually have already announced where we don't need any kind of approval.
Correct.
Such as an Vodafone clearly is a case where they are likely to increase the stake.
Sure.
Post the FDI investment being permitted. Mm. Such kind of things which are there are certain companies that are going for a buyback of shares.
Sure.
All put together, I think we'll probably see the inflows increasing.
So you're basically saying that the FI capital flows that we've seen over $20 billion over 2013, you're seeing that being consistent.
True.
What about domestic investor money? A large part of 2013, we didn't see confidence coming back from a retail investor standpoint. From a mutual fund AMC standpoint, are you seeing investor appetite returning?
I think clearly we saw the trend emerging. Mm. I would measure this in a two form. Mm. One is what is the behavior of the investors when it comes to the question of investing in mutual funds. Mm. I think clearly the confidence now is coming back. Mm. For one simple factor, that if you look back at the return of the equity schemes, the last 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 5 year, 10 year, mm. these are all now in positive. That is one. Mm. And second is 75% of the Indian mutual fund industry on the equity space have outperformed the respective indices, mm. ranging from 1 to 3%, 1 to 3% or 1 to 5%. That's
right.
I think biggest change that we have seen mm. in the recent past. And third, of course, is in other asset classes in which predominantly the Indian investors have been investing, mm. which is real estate, mm. and second is the gold. Mm. These are the two asset classes today are facing their own problem. So gold as an asset class is now getting stagnated, mm. and last 1 year, 3 year return has been very poor. Mm. So which again makes people believe that is an asset class where I need to continue to make investment or should I look at some other alternatives.
Mm.
Second is as far as real estate concerned, there is a bit of stagnation that we are already seeing it. Mm. The kind of volume that used to happen, mm. I think the big change that has happened in the recent past in the real estate is actually the drop in the volume. Mm. It's actually now started making people believe that the liquidity of such kind of investment is going to be poor.
Sure.
So having said these two things,
sure.
Clearly I think I see an improvement that is coming into the equity as an asset class.